Thanks for choosing us on this Thanksgiving night. I'm Faye Fredericks.
And I'm Zach Crenshaw. Families adjusting their plans this year amid this pandemic, and local schools doing the same. The Saguaro High School football season now coming to an abrupt end after more positive tests on the team. The news coming just one day before their scheduled playoff game.
ABC 15's Nicole Valdez talking to a Saguaro player tonight. She joins us now with more.
Yeah, the team's starting quarterback understandably taking this one pretty hard. He and the team have been working nonstop, overcoming every obstacle this pandemic's put in their way. And now he's really trying to be the glue that keeps the team together despite this unexpected ending.
Saguaro High School was steamrolling its competition, 5-1, the third seed in their playoff bracket. Starting varsity quarterback Junior Ridge Dutchikal had visions of end zones when he thought about the coming weeks.
We've been working at this since January in the weight room, and we've overcome so many obstacles together as a team. I feel we had a really good shot at winning the whole thing too.
The Sabercats season, all preparation for the playoffs, set to begin Friday against South Point Catholic High School in Tucson. Then they got the call.
Obviously no news that anyone wants to hear Thanksgiving morning.
The program forced to shut down for 8 days per AIA protocol after 3 players tested positive.
We took all the precautions. I mean, it's definitely frustrating, but I mean, obviously main priority is to be safe, and you know, that comes first.
Saguaro's head coach Jason Mons heartbroken, tweeting, "Our players have done everything we've asked of them to stay safe and protect their season." Meanwhile, hundreds of youth sports teams flocking to Arizona this weekend despite similar risks. Thousands of kids set to play in hockey, soccer, basketball, and baseball tournaments across the valley.
It is what it is. It's out of our control, but we just got to keep moving forward.
But Dutchikal keeping his chin up.
There could be a lot of worse things going on right now, and I mean, it's tough. Like, football is most of our lives, and you know, you just got to look at the positives. Like, we did get some games in this year, and we've created some bonds and friendships that will last forever.
And he'll be ready to step under center again in 2021.
I'm just proud of my team, and I couldn't be more thankful for an amazing coaching staff. And hopefully we'll have another opportunity next year to go win it all.
Nicole Valdez, ABC 15, Arizona.